looks like Congress may have reached a compromise to avoid the March 4th government shutdown this Friday, but it's a two-week stopgap budget deal that only includes $4 billion in cuts and is far from a done deal. So if there is a government shutdown, will Democrats gain an advantage over Republicans like they did back in 1995?
Joining us right now is former Maryland governor, Republican congressman during the 1995 government shutdown, Bob Ehrlich. Welcome, congressman slash governor. Thanks for joining us.
You guys are bringing back bad memories here, let me tell you.
All right, I'm sorry about that, but it is something that happened that took place. It's the school of thought that Republicans paid the price for that shutdown. At that
to
time,
to some extent,
$165 billion was our debt. Now it's much more serious. We're in the trillions. Would they still pay the price should that happen?
Maybe not. This is a different environment. This is what this election was all about. It's not just what the Tea Party movement is truly lobbying for, but also a lot of independents, a lot of moderates, a lot of Democrats. We had a huge election cycle here. People said, we want change. We want entitlement reform. Get a hold of the budget. It's not the same environment as it was in 1995, 1996. That was more of a Republican deal, the contract with America, Newt, and all that.
Right.
This is more a fiscal tide. This is get your house in order, Washington, D.C., or if Republicans you don't do it, we'll find somebody who will.
Sure. And as a veteran of that government shutdown, internally in your caucus, you know, there were hardliners who said, look, it's okay if we shut down. But then the moderates were going, you can't do this. So your advice to the Congress right now is don't do it, right?
It broke down philosophically and regionally. The northeastern, more moderate members, obviously Maryland, here I am coming from Maryland. A lot of government employees, a lot of federal government employees, very unpopular. It's not South Carolina. It's not Oklahoma. It's not Texas. So you really saw it break down along geographical lines and philosophical lines. But my advice in the piece in the Post yesterday was, John Boehner, this leadership, they've been through it. They know what they're doing. Let your leaders lead. It's a different time in America. The people are real serious this time. And unlike 1995, 1996, entitlement reform, savings with regard to discretionary spending is something people want to see coming out of Washington, D.C.
I guess. Well, that's what the speaker thought last night, and that's what he thinks now as he spoke to a group last night. And let's hear it.
In other words, we're broke. Broke going on bankrupt. And just as a bankrupt business has trouble creating jobs, so does a bankrupt country. Italy, Spain, Greece, Ireland, even France, face sovereign debt crisis and social unrest. Much of our debt has been bought up by China and Japan. Gas prices are rising. Economists have laid out the nightmare scenarios that we may soon confront.
I need a Prozac. What's going on there? He's laid it out. He's serious about it. But I see this should make you feel better, Mr. Ehrlich. Representative Kevin Brady of Texas says we're more likely to be hit by an asteroid than have a government shutdown. He doesn't think it's going to happen.
Well, I hope it doesn't. Nobody wants it to happen, but you have to make the president serious about entitlement reform. You have to make the president lead, and that's what all this pressure is about. That's why I'm here this morning. That's why Speaker Boehner made his speech. That's what the people are saying with regard to their emails, their phone calls, everything going into Washington, D.C. This election, we meant to have consequences. Elections always have serious consequences. But in this time in our history, people are saying, yes, federal government, we actually want you to do something.
Right.
It's not situational. There's enough pressure out there where there's an expectation if the Republicans don't do it, as I said earlier, they will pay the price.
Gotcha.
Come next election cycle.